Alright, so hey guys, what is up? It's Twinstar here and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I want to be making it super quick and you know on to the point. I'll just I will just cover all the queries you guys have. So in today's video, I'll be telling you how I record my Minecraft videos, but this will be applicable for every single one of you guys. I want you guys to tell is that just use this method if you have a really low end, you know, gear or PC, whatever. So right, I'll just write down my specs in the description. So I'll just tell you right now, it's an i3 8th generation and 8 gigs of RAM. Okay, I don't have a GPU or anything, so let's just go to the settings. Let's just make this really quick. Okay, so if you don't know how to make the dark mode, you can actually, you know, do from here. From the general tab, you can change it to the dark mode from here. The stream thing, we don't need to use any of this. So let's just start from the bottom, which is much more better. So go to your advanced tab. So this is the advanced tab. So the process priority means how much CPU usage you want to give. So the number one mistake most of you guys make is to put it on high. Don't use it. So if you're, you know, recording a gameplay or gaming video, it's not good because most of your frames will now decrease from the gaming video. From the game. So if I put this on high and if I play Minecraft, if my typical frames is 90, I will only get 60 below. Okay, you're gonna lose a lot of frames. Okay, the color space, I put it on 709. This all comes to personal preference. I mean, color range is to full. Always put it to full, it's better. On some games only it's better, like for black and white game or something, you can put it on partial, don't worry. For a colorful game like, or any FPS type of game, put it on full. So anyway, color format is NV12 and direct, this board don't change, it's set to default like this, don't change this. And to the below one, don't do any single thing, you're gonna make it worse only if you change this. So hotkeys, I don't use any of the hotkeys. So if you guys want, you can put anything. Yeah, so coming to the next part, okay? The video tab. This is a little bit more important. So I tend to record mostly on 1080p, which is much more better. So 1080p means the much more more pixels in your screen, so much more clarity. So try to use 1080p. 720p will be a little bit more blurry type thing, so don't use it. But if your PC only allows you till 720p, just use it. Okay, so I put it to bilinear. Don't try to there's no need for you to increase it. You can just max go till area if you want, if you have a very low spec PC like me. Don't go to bicubic, it's just more CPU usage. Bilinear or area, just use that. And for the frames, you can put any frames you want, but try to test it out. When I use 60 frames and play Minecraft, it lags a lot. 30 frames is, how much frames you increase, it's much more smoother the video is, much more clear, it's more crispier. Crispier, what the heck. Okay, so I use it at 48. It gives you that smoothness of the 60 frames and it's not that CPU intensive as well. So 48 frames is for me. Keep it on bilinear, 1080p. Alright, so if 1080p doesn't work for you, you can put your output, to 720p, then you can put it to bilinear, don't need to change that, but you can increase it to 60, just try to increase it, you'll have a really smooth gameplay. You know, Technoblade used to put 720p 60 frames video, that's why the older video looks very, blurry and pixelated. Now, Minecraft is a pixelated game, so it won't affect a lot, but it's okay. So coming to the audio tab, this is only two things, put it on stereo, don't put it on mono, it will be very bad. And there are two types of sample rate, 44.1 and 48. 44.1 is much more better for less CPU usage, so I use that only. You can increase it, there is not a big of a difference. But I just tend to stick it on 44.1. You can change to 48 hertz, don't worry. Okay, so the next one is the output one. Okay, So here, all the new creators make the mistake. They go see a video and they put it to advanced tab. Please don't do it. Please don't do it at all, please. Okay, so advanced tab is better if you have a mid-range PC. So you can tweak it to your personal preference, but don't use advanced, please. It's a lot of stuff going on. So just take simple. It's so simple to work with the simple mode. Oh, sorry. Go to the recording tab. Put it to high quality medium files. Don't increase it, don't decrease it. This is the best one. Okay. The recording format, it depends on your editing, this one. What editor you use. If you are using Premiere Pro, use MP4. I use shortcut, so it supports every type of format. So I use MKV. MKV also, if your PC crashes also your recording won't be lost, so that's a really good use. So the encoder, the next part. Encoder, there are three types for me. One is software, which is X264. Software one is there for low CPU usage, and there is a hardware which is QSV. This is the one I'm using. So test it out, which is the best. Software means you're using your CPU for recording, which I don't recommend, but if you don't have any other choice, but you have to use that itself. If you have a graphics card, you can use an NVENC. NVENC is so super good for recording. You can use an NVENC. Okay, I'll just type it out if you guys didn't understand. Okay, yeah, so that's just it. Okay, so that's how I record my stuff, 1080p 48 frames on bilinear scale. So right now what I'll be doing is to show you two separate things. One is 1080p 48 frame, just you guys, I have seen people, not differentiate between should you guys use 1080p 30 frames or 720p 60 frames, which might be little bit more better if we are comparing a game like Minecraft. So here is a short demonstration between two. So yeah, you can watch that right now.
Royalty free music.
Right, so that means we are in the end of the video. Thank you guys for so much for watching till the end, and yeah, bye. See you guys in next video. And yeah, so right now you studied how to record a gameplay, right? So how about you study how to make a thumbnail? Yeah, so click the video right in front of you. You can make an amazing thumbnail right now. I'll post it. The next video might be on the thumbnail, and just click the video right in front of you right now. Okay, so bye, have a great day.